I make sure that they use whatever government program which has come to change the life of our people. We should not now continue lamenting without actually participating in making sure that our people take their rights in their hands. So this is what the thing which I heard some statement like that. I thought I should make it clear that the responsibility is ours who are elected. Once you are elected, it is your responsibility to turn your people around. In my constituency, I've turned them around.
In my constituency, Lamor, I've turned them around. I made sure that they've now forgotten about the IDPs. Frustrations are finished. No more suicide. People are working. And then we make sure we go around in the field as leaders to make sure that we mobilize them to produce. Now we have opened up huge sugar plantations there next to Atiak Sugar. We shall have massive sugar production. We are going to install irrigation systems there. And so we want to turn the population around. So leaders must work together, not only with government, but also with elected leaders in the district to utilize the facilities which are there. Instead of pumping hatred, a lot of bickering, intrigue, confusing people to take advantage of our illiterate, sometimes not illiterate, but maybe less informed population. Our people must be helped to stand on their feet and not to have more suicide here. And then this is my concern as a local leader here, because I also 100% of my people were in IDP camps. And now they are rehabilitating themselves, they are picking the pieces, they are settling down, they are cultivating. A lot of Simsim today, which is in Lira, Soli, Lira, all come from my district. They buy them, they go and buy them cheaply, then Lira become the main supplier to Kampala. Next time I'm stopping it going to Lira, they must buy from my place. Those traders from Kampala must come and buy from Kipum so that they leave their bigger money than the small money which our people get because they are pressed with the school fees. They sell Simsim for about 1,500, 2,000. And then in Lira, they buy, they take to Kampala, it's 4,000, 5,000 shillings per kilo. These are some of the challenges. We as leaders, we have a role to play. We have a role to play to transform our people. And when we do that, we shall help the church. Because the church, while they are focusing on really harmony, peaceful coexistence, and doing things that God approves, if we don't play our part, the church alone will not be able to help in the prosperity, creation of prosperity work. When we work jointly with the church, then all our messages will be complete. It will be one for the soul, and then the other one for the body is by us, who are leaders. So it is something which I thought I should mention here because, you know, that dependent syndrome which was there, and blame game and so on, must stop, and we must concentrate on work and production. I want to go back to the good side, and we thank the Orthodox Church. And I've already mentioned my views there that more the church, the Christian churches, must really spread out and not really operate from within the church precincts and live, stay there. The people are outside there. We must have more catechists venturing out, maintaining the faith and also spreading, following. If you don't do that, we are dwindling. Atheists and other negative forces are capturing your folk. Eventually, you find that you become the minority, like in Northern Africa or places where the nuns, the priests and so on, they locked themselves in the monastery, and then they let these marauding forces move around, and then married many wives, did everything, and turned the whole place around. So Christianity disappeared in those places. So our philosophy, our approach should be different, should be more pragmatic, aggressive. Go to the population, get them on board, get the good values Christianity gives. Christianity is the value of love, brotherhood, irrespective of your thinking. irrespective of what you believe in, but you are a brother, you are a human being like me. And then we must follow in that direction. That way, there will be eternal peace here on earth. If we don't do like that, we shall perish with time. So these are briefly my small messages. Otherwise, thank you very much. I would wish to stay until the end. The messages you gave me, I will take to His Excellency the President. And I will communicate to him to tell him to come back to Gulu and tomorrow as quickly as possible in order to, among other things, visit the Orthodox Church here, give them encouragement through the discussion they had with the Metropolitan and so forth. Otherwise, God bless you all. Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, my name is Engineer Onek Hillary, Member of Parliament Lamour, and in Cabinet. Thank you.
You're welcome very much, and thank you for your message. I know that Honorable Minister, please.